phone number is 201-209-9368. If you have a question for Andy Daly, and then later, we're going to, as we wrap up the final thing, we do a segment on the show now with guests called Match Wits with Mike.
Mm-hmm.
Mike is the associate producer of the show.
Yes, I'm aware.
And he is going to ask you a series of questions.
Okay.
And you'll see if you can match wits with Mike.
I'm going to beat him. I'll just say that right now.
You hear that, Mike?
Yeah.
Mike said no problem.
I'm going to embarrass him.
You're going to embarrass Mike?
Yeah, I think so.
With questions that he knows the answer to? You just set the bar pretty high. I will say 201-209-9368 if you have a question for Andy Daly.
He thinks he knows the answer to these questions.
He thinks he knows the answer to his own questions.
Yep, I'm going to open his eyes a little bit. Mm-hmm.
Let me ask you a question. This is something I've been trying to figure out. It's something I'm going to do as an ongoing thing. Mm-hmm. Who, in your estimation, is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young?
I think it's got to be Stephen Stills.
Then what would you base that upon?
I saw a documentary called Festival at Big Sur, which was fascinating. It was a music festival at Big Sur, as the title implies, and it took place 3 months after Woodstock, and already the fun of Woodstock was over. It was just a pale shadow, and things were getting sour, and Stephen Stills. Some guy in the audience starts yelling at Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young that they're sellouts, and it's just an argument between two idiots, and Stills eventually starts to run off stage to attack him, to attack the guy, and he has to be restrained by his friends and all. And then he gives a speech about how, things got real hairy there, but I'm glad I had some friends to love me out of it.
Ugh,
give me a break.
That's gross. I think you just sealed this debate is over, perhaps.
I came loaded with ammunition on that one. I've had it in for Stephen Stills ever since I saw that.
We're going to go to the phones now. People are going to ask questions.
Hot dog. Of
Andy Daly. FMU, you're on the air. Look, no offense. These people see me. They all want to be me. All of them. All want to trade places. Not going to happen. This is not 18 again. This is not vice versa. We are not in some wish fulfillment fantasy where you can change places with another human. I built myself into this. You think I was born this way? I was the biggest loser on 2 feet. Then I looked in the mirror. I splashed some cold water on my face. And I said, you, sir, are going to go for it each and every day. No matter what the consequence, you're going to go for it. Minutes left. The topic on the table is... who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young? 201-209-9368. Everybody's got an opinion. Andy Daly weighed in. He said it's Stephen Stills. Could it be Neil Young? Is Neil Young dumber than you think? Maybe it's the dim-witted Graham Nash with his bad Our House type songs. Who is it? Or is it crazy David Crosby? 201-209-9368. Who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young? I don't know how anybody can't be depressed by this Jay Leno taking over 5 nights of NBC now a week. That is the most depressing development in television I can imagine. 5 nights of that swill tying up your television. That's like NBC getting out of the television business. FMU, you're on the air.
Stephen Stills.
Stephen Stills?
He's as dumb as David Crosby is smart.
And why is this? Let me do this. I'm putting on my paper a C, an S, an N, and a Y, and the votes are going to be tabulated. So he is as dumb as what?
As David Crosby is smart.
Wow.
Or at least articulate.
All right, fair enough. So we have two votes for Stills. 201-209-9368. FMU, you're on the air.
Hi, Tom. How you doing?
I'm doing all right. Who's this?
It's Andrew in Philadelphia.
Andrew in Philadelphia, quality caller.
Thank you. It's Neil Young.
And why do you say it's Neil Young?
I love Neil Young, but just for the fact that he got mixed up with those jokers.
You want to know what? That might be the greatest point ever, that this guy signed on to play with the three dumb... Who is the dumbest one here? The three dummies or the smart guy who goes into business with three dummies for 35 years?
That's right.
Solid point. Thank you, Andrew.
Sorry
to cut you off there, buddy. 201-209-9368. Who's the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young? FMU, you're on the air.
I got to say Nash.
You got to say Nash. Why Nash?
Because he's the only one that hasn't been James like you have just now. I did it again, Tom. I swear I did it.
I can't help it.
That guy is... You want to know the sad part? I talked to this guy now, James, a.k.a. Jeremy. I talked to him on email. This guy's the most helpful guy with behind-the-scenes stuff on the show. You want to know what? I'm going to let that slide. You want to know what? This is going to hurt him the most. Right now, there is no such thing as Jamesing me, because he's welcome to call and do that. His vote counts, though, Nash. So right now in the tally for who's the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young, two for Stills, one for Nash, and one for Young. 201-209-9368. Who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young? Let's find out. Your vote counts on this. I start my Twitter novel this week. Twitter.com/Scharpling. Not yet. The title will be revealed when the writing begins. You'd think this topic would have gotten the phones glowing like lightning bugs. Yes, this topic was like a comet. All four phones were lit up instantly, and then now we have not received one phone call. I thought I had hit on the ultimate topic, because within 15 seconds, every phone line was lit up. Who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young? FMU, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, who's this?
It's James in South Orange.
How are you, James?
I'm good. It's weird to hear you say James, and I'm not going to scream, "You got James," or anything like that. But I got to say David Crosby.
You say David Crosby. Why is that?
Well, somebody's got to say David Crosby. But also, I mean, the guy, you know, drank himself into oblivion, like destroyed his liver. It's pretty stupid, you know?
Fair enough.
All right. I thought you'd appreciate that. So
I appreciate
there you
it.
Go. There's the vote.
Thanks, James. Who would be the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, Young, and Fredericks? If that guy was in Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young. FMU, you're on the air. Hello? No? Nothing? 201-209-9368. FMU, you're on the air.
Tom?
Yes.
My name is Paycheck in Toronto.
Oh, it's Paycheck. This is a super caller.
Oh, yeah.
Power caller, whatever it's called now.
I've got dual citizenship. I got both.
You do?
I want to say David Crosby is the dumbest.
And what would make you, who you are a bit of a rock scholar.
Yes.
Paycheck.
And I have to actually pull out the copy of Shaky, who by Jimmy McDonough.
I know where you're going with this.
And he said, David Crosby once said, the reason that Neil Young toured with Crazy Horse instead of CSNY was because we cost too much money. Not because Crazy Horse is awesome.
Yeah.
It just came down to a dollars and cents.
He was a guy. Crosby is a guy who openly blasted Crazy Horse. Like, he's playing with these idiots.
Yeah, these guys, they're not very good.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, you know, the guy doesn't get it. He just doesn't get it. That's it.
You want to know what paycheck?
What's that?
Much like your handle, you are money in the bank.
Happy holidays, Tom.
Same to you. Do you guys have Christmas up there?
Yeah, but it's like a Thanksgiving.
Like
it's early. We already had it. Yeah.
You already had it. All right. You take care, paycheck.
Thanks. Bye.
201-209-9368. Who's the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young? FMU, you're on the air.
Hi.
Hi, who's this?
This is Stone in Florida.
How are you, Stone?
I'm doing great.
Your real name isn't Stone, is it?
It is, actually, yeah.
What are you going to be? Are you born into a family of weathermen?
Of sorts. We'll go ahead and say that. You know, I'm going to go ahead and jump on the David Crosby train.
And what is your reasoning behind that?
Because he gave his sperm to Melissa Etheridge.
Fair enough. Toilet mouth. Get sick with that talk. It's disgusting. What am I running here? Is this a series of peep show booths? Am I running? Are we at 42nd Street? No. This is a quality radio show for the family. And you got that prevert. And they've done so many combinations, Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young. Like, when Young won't join them, it's either Crosby, Stills, and Nash. There is a Crosby-Nash album, I believe. Is there a Crosby-Nash album, Mike? There is a Crosby-Nash album, right? Is there a Stills-Young album? Yeah. So these guys have almost done every combination. FMU, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom. It's Mike in Manhattan. How you doing tonight?
I'm doing all right. How are you, Mike?
Pretty good. Pretty good. Just wanted to let you know that the Simpsons episode that Crosby, Stills, and Nash guest star on is going to be on in about 13 minutes. So what a coincidence.
Is it a coincidence? Or
yeah.
Is it viral marketing?
I'm a rep from Fox. What can I say?
So tell me, young man, do you have a vote on this?
You know, all three-way tie except for
there are no such thing as three-way ties. So anyway, do you have an opinion on this, Petey?
Yeah, I actually do.
Who do you think is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young?
Yeah, well, you know, I don't really have much of knowledge on country music, but I would have to say Young, just because he's so young, and, you know, he's going to stay young forever. So I think, like, he's not going to grow up, and he's just going to be ignorant forever, so he's probably the dumbest one.
You want to know what the sad
part is? That's my opinion.
That vote counts. That's the sad part about this.
That's not sad. I have a valid opinion.
Just like in America, anyone can vote.
Yeah.
FMU, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom, it's Rory from Bristow again.
Rory from Bristow. How are you, Rory?
Oh, I'm sorry. It's Raj. I think it's a bad connection. Raj.
Okay, Raj. Do you have a vote on this?
Yes, I do. I was looking through and trying to figure out who's responsible for American Dream, and I got to say it's Neil Young, so that's where my vote is.
All right. Neil Young is tied with Crosby. Thanks for the call, Rory. He's tied 3 for Crosby, 2 for Stills, 1 for Nash, 3 for Young. Who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young? FMU, you're on the air.
Hi, Tom.
Hi, who's this?
This is Power Caller Erica from
Power
Baltimore.
Caller, how are you tonight?
I'm great.
Do you have a vote for us?
I do, and it was based on the earlier caller's opinion of Neil Young. Yep.
So young?
No, no, not Petey. And his driving mysticism. But
the thing is, the Young is so young, and he'll always be young.
Petey needs to slow down. He's gonna burn out young.
Is that what meditation does to the human brain? If so, keep me away from it. This is my meditation. This is what I meditate. I grab an eight ball. from a pool table, and I squeeze it. It's going to either, it'll break or my fingers will break. That's my philosophy. I'm going to keep squeezing that thing till it breaks.
That's some pretty heavy meditation.
It is.
Yes.
So who do you think is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young?
Neil Young, because he played with those guys.
Fair enough. He's in the lead.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Thank you, Eric.
Bye.
Did you ever think, Mike, you would see a day when this topic was put on the table and Neil Young would be in the lead?
Yeah, surprising. Have you heard the banter on the new bootleg, though?
201-209-9368. The banter on the new bootleg. No, I have not.
Pretty bad.
Is that the one from the late 60s?
Yeah, special.
Oh. Let's get some more calls here.
Yeah, he was very
FMU, you're on the air.
Crosby's the dumbest, for sure.
And why is that?
Just the mustache alone.
Okay, the fact that he would choose to grow that mustache.
That in that particular fashion, yes.
That mustache, that's like a Mario Brothers. He should have played one of the Mario Brothers in that movie.
He may have been the original inspiration.
Yeah. Thank you very much. 201-209-9368. Who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young? Hot and cold on this one. Either the phones are all lit up, or these calls trickle in, or they're dead like they are now. This is embarrassing. Boom, boom, boom. I've never seen the phones this silent. Unbelievable. For such a hot topic. I guess it's very polarizing. FMU, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, who's this?
Dan.
Dan from?
Manhattan.
From Manhattan. How are you, Dan?
I'm doing fine, thanks.
Do you have an opinion on this?
Yeah, I do. Actually, Crosby's got to be the most stupid person involved.
And why is that?
Well, let's remember back, in 82, 83, he got arrested for having a gun, right?
Yes.
Where was he? He was in Texas. Everybody has a gun. How can you be arrested in Texas for having a gun when everybody else has one?
Yeah. What did he have it in his mouth? Like, was he holding the handle in his mouth? You're right. Texas, everybody's a wacko walking around with a gun in Texas.
Why do you think they have a town called Wacko? Oh, I'm sorry, Waco.
Oh, look out.
Hey, now.
So you vote for Crosby.
Yeah, oh, yeah, he's crazy as a
yeah, poop. Yeah. I don't want to hear your... 201-209-9368. Only 4 minutes left. And then Evan Funk Davies comes in. And he's got an exciting show planned for you, which I'll tell you about in a couple minutes. FMU, you're on the air.
Yeah, I vote Crosby.
And why do you vote Crosby? In and out of the voting booth on that guy. I vote Crosby. FMU, you're on the air.
Okay. They're all equally dumb.
So you want to vote for everyone?
Yeah, because they've all agreed to play with each other. looks like a pack of idiots.
You want to know what? You might be dead on with that. All four of them look at the other three and say, "Yeah, all right."
Yeah, I mean, that's all I got.
All right, thanks for the call. Unfortunately, you cannot vote four times. This is a point you could make, though, for Stills. Stephen Stills was in Buffalo Springfield with Neil Young, which was his group, and he watched it slowly get taken over by Neil Young. Then the group breaks up. Stephen Stills goes and gets his own thing going, Crosby, Stills, and Nash. Enormous. They're so huge, right off the bat. He's got his own thing now. So what does Stephen Stills do? After he went through a struggle with this other guy, Neil Young, over who ran this band, Stephen Stills had his thing now. Crosby, Stills, Nash. Neil Young would never even be a fraction as popular as Crosby, Stills, and Nash. Stephen Stills says, you know what we should do is invite Young to join the group. And Neil Young promptly takes over his second group. The other point why I think I would vote for Stephen Stills on this, the song Love the One You With, Love the One You're With, had a guitar solo on it, recorded by who, Mike? Originally, the original version of it? You ever hear of Jimi Hendrix? Jimi Hendrix came in and did a solo for that song, played on it. Stephen Stills says to himself, you know what I think this song needs? I'm going to take this Jimi Hendrix solo off, and in its place, I am going to play steel drums on this record. FMU, you're on the air.
Hi, I'm definitely going for Nash on this one.
Wow, that's a new guy. I don't like that guy a little bit. I guess that's the way it goes when the show gets more popular. I'm going to have guys like that. Now that the show's getting bigger and bigger and bigger. It is. These morons are off from college. That might be one of the H-Man's dumb friends. I think there's like some crossover now. The H-Man's college. Look, the H-Man is a great guy. He's not dumb. He's one of the smartest young men I've ever met. But this crew he rolls with? Oh, boy. FMU, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom, I agree with that. That was ridiculous. Like, what was up with that guy?
See, I don't like a guy who's talking too much about that guy means he's about to be that guy. Yeah. So I guess Crosby is, as voted by you people tonight, the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young. This is WFMU East Orange, WXHD Mount Hope, worldwide on the World Wide Web at WFMU.org. Please stay tuned for Evan Funk Davies. I'm not ready to abandon, I'm not ready to abandon this topic from last week. I feel very, disillusioned that a topic was such a, it ran hot and flamed out after 2 minutes. So, you know what? I'm trying it again. We're going into new territory here. I'm reviving a topic that I believe in. The topic is, who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young? 201-209-9368. Call up now. Who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young? This is a winner. I refuse to give up on this topic. 201-209-9368. David Crosby, Stephen Stills, Graham Nash, and Neil Young. Which one is the dumbest? And the phones are quiet. I'm not giving up on it. I can't weigh in. I'll tip everything that way. People will. I'll spike the results. 201-209-9368. Who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young? FMU, you're on the air.
Hi, this is Rickan calling from Vancouver.
Oh, hi. How are you tonight?
Good. How are you?
Doing okay. Do you have an opinion on the topic on the table?
And I feel bad for being a Canadian and voting this way, but my vote has to be for Neil Young.
Oh, and why is that?
Human Highway.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
The album, the movie Human Highway.
The movie, just silly, and that epic jam with Devo in the end just didn't really do it for me. I thought it brought out the worst of both acts.
You know what? Your vote has been counted. And I'm picking up where we left off last week, just so you know.
Mm-hmm.
Count, including your vote, we are at 6 votes for Crosby,
mm-hmm.
2 for Stills, 1 for Nash, and 5 for Young.
Okay.
Counting your vote.
Pulling up there.
Yes. Thank you, young man.
Thanks very much. Have a good night.
FMU, you're on the air.
You know, I have to start off by saying Neil Young, simply because he has an offspring.
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. I'm Charlie. I'm sorry.
You don't say hi?
Hi. I was a little keyed up.
What is this?
By the way,
what is this, C-SPAN?
I can't believe I discovered the show.
Welcome. Welcome.
Just because Neil Young has a developmentally disabled offspring doesn't mean anything, okay? Cortez the Killer, that title alone takes him out of the running. All right, Stephen Stills is a tremendous slide guitar player, all right? And he put together that little acoustic outfit that played their first gig at that farm a little bit north of the city. I think you might have heard of it.
No, what are you talking about?
It's named after a farm, Yazgur, I think. It was named after a band.
Yazgur, what is that?
Farm, yeah.
I don't know what that is.
That's a little off topic, but it's got to be David Crosby.
And why is that?
Well, it's not because of the addiction, because addiction is a disease. It's a physiological disease. It affects all the major systems. It affects a person psychologically, emotionally, and physically. That's why they can't get help for themselves, but that's also off topic. That isn't it. Can I mention a marriage between a female adult-oriented rock singer that came around 1990, Melissa Etheridge? A little donation that he made to the Union of
Souls. Yeah. Okay, yeah, I get it.
Runaway. Okay?
Is that what makes Crosby the dumbest?
Yes. That and the fact that he left Buffalo Springfield to make a solo record.
Yeah, that Crosby did. Remember that?
It's been expunged from the collective memory of the entire generation,
uh-huh.
whose failure of imagination we are now wallowing in, by the way. Mm-hmm. Maybe this Barack fella
can
do something about that.
When exactly was Crosby in Buffalo Springfield?
I'm sorry, my computer froze.
You only know this stuff online, huh?
No, that was a joke.
Wikipedia?
You know something? You ever listen to public radio, you know, the low-paid Lera guys? They throw the word wiki around. Let's start a wiki.
No, I don't listen to that garbage.
I had to ask someone. I was embarrassed. But I'm a little older, so I'm not so self-conscious about not knowing the hip current colloquialisms and euphemisms.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying.
So how did you find this show by Charlie?
I was fixing up in the car in Brooklyn Heights, and
you mean like heroin?
No, but you know, an injectable narcotic, nonetheless. And I had the radio on low because I needed the light from the dial. You know that Elvis song, tuning in the shine of the late night dial. But I wasn't doing anything my radio advised that night because there was a fella named Hammerhead on.
Yeah.
Fan-freaking-tastic. I believe that's not one of the 7, is it?
Yeah. Hey, somebody else wants to talk to you. Hold on 1 second.
You got to write that book.
FMU, you're on the air.
Hello, Tom?
Yeah.
Frederick's here.
How's this? You wanted to talk to this guy, Frederick's?
Did I?
Yeah, where are you calling?
Was he putting down Neil Young?
No.
Where are you calling from, Frederick?
Amplifiers and the residents wearing the lighted goggles and the hoods that were leftover wardrobe items from A New Hope.
The residents?
Which was never referred to as A New Hope. It was always just Star Wars. Now it's A New Hope.
Tom.
Anyway, when Luke is going through the valley with the land speeder to, do some stuff to save humanity. He runs into those little munchkins with the sackcloth.
Where did this come from?
Well, there's a video, and it's a live concert where Neil Young and Crazy Horse play some selections. And the set is decorated with gigantic amplifiers.
This is crazy.
And it's to scale so that Neil and the band appear to be no higher than a German hand grenade bottle of Budweiser next to a Marshall stack, if you get what
I'm saying. Oh, I got it. It's kind of like Spinal Tap and where were
yes,
they?
The Stonehenge. In that case, the Pebblehenge.
Mm, right, correct.
Well,
so who are you?
Neil, I got to go.
Hey, wait a minute. Oh, this is radio.
What's up, Fredericks?
This is weird radio. How did that happen?
I don't know. The lines got crossed somehow.
Well, who is that guy?
I don't know. I thought you had put him through.
No, he's not one of my crew. Guarantee. Anyways, Graham Nash is the bad one. I was so upset last week when Neil Young was winning.
What? You were bummed out when Neil Young was winning, the dumbest member of Crosby.
Graham Nash only had one vote. I want to give him another one.
Graham, why do you want to give Graham Nash another vote?
Well, all those guys came from other bands, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Well, and what band did he come from?
The Hollies.
And there you go. Compared to what? Buffalo Springfield.
The Birds. Right?
Yeah, and the Minor Birds.
Yeah.
You remember them?
Yeah, you know what? You don't remember them either, you
liar. No, I wasn't that old. No, Tom.
No one remembers them. You just know about
James
them.
James and Neil Young in the same band, though.
Yeah, did you still listen to that album a lot?
I never even heard it.
Because it didn't come out.
It's just mythological.
How did that never come out, Mike? How has that in the 40 years not been released?
Because it's a lie?
Well, Fredericks is blowing my mind.
That's a good question.
Hey, Fredericks.
Yes, sir. I wanted to correct you on a couple things if I ever get a chance.
Please, the floor is yours.
Okay. Well, first, this is kind of a compliment, I think. But I got your Coltrane joke when you were talking about Ohm being on the John Coltrane MySpace page. That would not be the tune that they'd put up there.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Well, it must have been just a passing idea, and you said, oh, here I go doing jazz jokes. Well, one person got it. That's all I wanted to let you know. Two is Pete Seeger did not cut the cord at the, 65 Newport Folk Festival. He wanted them to turn it down because he liked the words to Maggie's Farm so much. I saw that in a documentary. And you're spreading a false meme.
What?
Mm-hmm.
No, he chopped the thing and he got electrocuted.
Yeah, right. Well, think about that, Tom. And he chopped it with an axe. Like, the guy shows up with his little axe. Well, did you hang up on me?
No. You're here.
Something bad happened. We got hit by lightning. Oh, I'm sorry, the electricity got cut.
That was weird.
That was very weird. We're talking about Pete Seeger.
So who was that guy was that guy picking up on an extension in your house, Fredericks?
I thought he was a friend of yours, Tom. I don't know who that cat was.
The call is coming from inside the house.
My house? Is that Mike? Who is that guy? Homeland
the
Security?
The call is coming from... Get out of the house!
Get out of the
house! Land sakes, get out now! No, this is Charlie, the drug addict again. I got to take issue with you with the Graham.
How did you get back in my house?
Any band mid Britpop
here
that makes a song like Bus Stop immediately floats up from the
bottom. Bus
Stop? Now I've got some stuff that I've got to take care of.
Tom?
Yes.
What the hell is going on?
I don't know.
This is the weirdest Christmas I ever had.
So, like, we're going back, like, maybe 5 minutes before that about something apparently has been going on for weeks, and I so apologize because I was off, you know.
Is the show playing at Creedmoor now?
About, like, Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young.
Yeah.
Okay. definitely David Crosby.
You think he's the dumbest?
Of course.
And why is that?
He couldn't handle his drugs. Please, I did more drugs than he ever did.
What?
I never went to rehab.
Hold on a second. What you're saying is you've abused drugs? I would never guess in a million years.
Yeah. Someone named Wilhelmina. Actually, I didn't abuse them.
Tell me, what's the hardest drug you did with any regularity?
Heroin.
Okay.
Heroin. And I'm glad I don't use that group and, you know, cry my eyes out. I mean, come on. You come to a point, you stop doing it. You don't give your sperm to some...
Ugh. I got to move on. Is this what Twitter is getting the show now? I joined Twitter, and then a week later, these are the callers. I'm telling you, where is this show getting pumped into? Because they're all in the same place. These are all the same person, basically, calling. FMU, you're on the air.
Yeah, this is Ben from Wilmington, North Carolina.
How are you, Ben?
I'm doing okay. How about you?
Doing okay.
Well, I got one for the topic.
Oh, let's hear it.
Well, I sort of hope it's Neil Young.
And why is that?
I was watching a performance of his. It was around the time Harvest came out, maybe a little bit before.
Uh-huh.
Just sort of an intimate setting and just him with an acoustic guitar. And he had this really, I guess, innocent and kind of sheepish quality about him. And I think that would, I admired that. And I think that would really kind of check out if he was the dumbest member. And it would kind of keep that innocent quality alive, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so you think that you're saying dumb in a good way?
Dumb in a, yeah.
Yeah, like in a childlike a way of untainted innocence.
Exactly. Playful and, you know, sincere.
All right. You know what? You have put dumb in a different in a different context.
Great. And that's really all I got.
Well, Ben, thank you so much.
Thank you.
You have a good night.
You too, Tom.
Who was this, Mike? Oh, God. FMU, you're on the air.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi, yes, this is Jane. Jane Paul from New York City.
Jean Paul from New York City.
No, Jane.
Jane.
Yes. I'm calling because as a mother, I disagree with that soccer mother who called in before from bad words and...
I can't even... I thought that person was cursing. I already bleeped them. Can't do the show anymore. Is this how we go out? No. Can't do it. Can't do it anymore. If you're thinking that my life is a hoot and a holler from the start of the day. Can't do it. The dark of the night. Can't do it anymore. And that it's ringing like a bell. I give up. That you only want to follow. Gotta trust me when I say. What? I'm just trying to get it right. Yeah, I'm just trying to get it right. Still I think about myself as a lucky old dreamer. That's me. And if you're asking me to tell, is it worth what I paid? You're gonna hear me say, hell yeah it is. And I say it loud, I loved it all. And I'm not too proud. I freed my soul. Just let it fly. All right. Hell yeah, this crazy life around me, it confuses and confounds me. But it's all the life I've got until I die. Hell yeah, it is. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, it is. If you're asking for my time, isn't much left to give you. I know.
Been around a good long while.
I have.
So I gotta say it fast. Time is all we'll ever need.
It is.
But it's gotta have a meaning.
Exactly.
You be careful how it's spent. Cause it isn't gonna last.
That's right.
I hear you wondering out loud. Are you ever gonna make? Will you ever work it out? Will you ever take a chance? And just believe you can. Hell yeah, you will.
I will!
You're gonna be okay.
I will be okay!
You might get lost. But then you'll find a way.
Thank you.
Don't go alone. Can't be afraid.
I can't be afraid.
Hell yeah, this life is here. It is made for living. And love's a gift that's made for giving. You give it all away and have it still. And hell yeah, it is. I've been living in a bowl.
Bowl? All right, you lost me there.
With a lot of people staring.
Oh, now I get it. Okay. A fishbowl. People staring at him.
With my feet on shaky ground.
Inside the bowl? Shaky ground inside the bowl?
And my head up in the sky.
This is some huge bowl.
But it's where I want to be.
Okay. You know what?
It's
I get
a life
it.
That's made for caring.
Yes.
Got a song to pass the day.
Not this
and
song.
A girl to share the night. So if they ask you when I'm gone, was it everything he wanted?
You hear this, people?
And when he had to travel on.
When I have to leave.
Did he know he'd be missed?
Just remember.
You can tell them this.
You animals.
Hell yeah, he did.
I did it! All of it.
He walked the line. Never had to crawl. He cried a bit.
Yes, I did.
But not for long.
Exactly. I was dusted by
hell
ball.
Yeah, he found the life that he was after. Filled it up with love and laughter. Finally got it right and made it fair. Hell yeah, he did.
I'm all fired up. I have no idea what that song was about. That song was the craziest thing I've ever heard. But now I get it. And just you all remember, when I'm gone, when this life, when you look back, you'll realize this is what it was all about. This show. When I'm gone. You didn't even see. You don't know how deep the iceberg went when this show's gone. FMU, you're on the air. So anyway, as I was saying. Yeah, I'm going to end 2008 the way I want to end it. The topic is, who is the worst member, who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young? Crosby, Stills, Nash, or Young? 201-209-9368. Who is the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young? 201-209-9368. Let's get those calls coming in now. Mike's doing that show out there again. A bad feeling on one. Bad feeling on one. All right, Mike. I'll trust you on that. FMU, you're on the air.
Hey, what's going on?
Not a whole lot. Who's this?
Dave from New Jersey.
Yeah, I agree with you, Mike. Who's the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young? This is the third week we're doing this. FMU, you're on the air.
Hi, Tom.
Hi, who's this?
Peter.
Peter from?
Boonton.
From Boonton. What can I do for you, Peter?
Hey,
I don't think there's any dumb member there. What do you got against CSNY?
So you don't have.
I love Neil Young. I heard this last week. You're getting on Neil Young for being dumb for hanging out with too long.
No, I'm not. I'm letting the callers say what they want. People called up and said that.
How about a new question? How about those shoes flying at Bush's head? That was pretty
funny. That's him. That's exciting. Let's talk about that.
Yeah. You know, do you know those Oxford have tripled in sales?
Oh, that's exciting. Yeah.
Yeah, stuff like that I like.
Yeah, good. Well, why don't you go over to Huffington Post then and get out of here. Heave-ho. FMU, you're on the air.
Abe here, Brooklyn.
Who?
Abe.
Abe, how are you tonight?
I'm a little blue. I'm a little blue, Tom.
So who's the dumbest member of Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young?
Easily David Crosby. I mean, how many times did that guy get busted for drugs guns?
Thanks, what? Abe. Good one. I appreciate it. FMU, you're on the air.
Yeah, I got to vote for David Crosby.
David Crosby? Why is that?
Yeah, like the guy before said, he was clearly, David Crosby is clearly, you know, had more problems with drugs and all of that. I just would hate to see Neil Young win because Neil Young is the one in the lead, and I like him the most.
All right, fair enough. Thank you. Right now, we're combining all the polls together on this. Crosby has 10, Stills 2, Nash 2, Young has 6, actually. FMU, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom, it's Mike from Mahwah again.
Mike from Mahwah, what do you have?
A vote for Crosby.
You vote for Crosby, why is that?
The cape.
You're right. He wore a cape.
Yeah.
Even though this is the thing. Could you imagine? This guy writes one of the best songs of the 60s, the song Everybody's Been Burned.
Uh-huh.
You know that song?
No, I don't know that one, Tom.
It goes something like this. Everybody has been burned before. Everybody knows the pain. Chilling song. But he's singing it in a cape. Ruins it. 201-209-9368 is the number. 201-209-9368. All four lines lit up. Watch this. FMU, you're on the air.
The H-Man died?
That's what I just heard. His brother just reported that.
Oh, no. What happened to him?
I don't know. We're waiting for an update.
You know what hospital he's at?
I don't know. Thank you. FMU, you're on the air.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi.
How are things up at Niagara Falls?
What?
FMU, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom, this is Brett in Colorado.
Brett in Colorado, how are you tonight?
I am just fine. This is an honor, sir, but this is really upsetting news. It kind of makes the CSNY question immaterial, doesn't it?
Show's got to go on. What can I do? H-Man was a good dude, but it happens.
With that said, Graham Nash, this guy is so smug and self-satisfied.
There we go.
And he's the most innocuous superstar in the history of rock music.
Great one. Thank you.
You're welcome, Tom. Happy New Year.
A happy New Year to you, too. FMU, you're on the air.
Hi, this is Sean, Studio City.
Sean in Studio City. You got something for the topic?
I wanted to vote for Neil Young just for the song, This Note's for You.
That's fair enough.
The lows was the reemergence of Kid Rock and all his nonsense.
That's
and
right.
The highs, obviously a victory for democracy, but on a best show note, the April 22nd edition of the best show with Paul F. and Billy Boy Roy, that was probably the high moment of my 2008.
I'm glad we could be a part of it. Thanks. Rest in peace, H-Man. We'll miss you. Evan has actually been generous enough. He's scrapping his year-end tribute. to 2008. He's going to do a tribute to the H-Man. He's going to play local H. He's going to play 3 hours of local H. All right. Well, that's how it goes sometimes. We're going to miss the H-Man. This has been the best show on WFMU. WFMU East Orange, WXHD Mount Hope, worldwide on the World Wide Web at WFMU.org. The best show wraps up another 2008. Well, not another one. It's the first one, only one we've wrapped up. Something's gone horribly wrong if I've wrapped one up before. I've been doing this show for a while. This year is in the books. We say goodnight. And we say goodbye to a dear friend, H-Man. Wait, I've just received word. Apparently he just has a cold. And he's okay. Someone just been getting faulty information. I apologize to anybody who's been scared. Stay tuned. Evan Funk Davies has an exciting three-hour show reviewing 2008, including exclusive audio from his trial earlier this year. Let's tune in and see what happens, shall we? Happy New Year!